Never when I entered nursing school did I ever think or believe that I would live through what we're living through right now, a pandemic in the United States.
Sometimes the most courageous thing is to just show up and to take care of patients and do what was necessary given all the unknowns.
Yes, we're in the middle of a pandemic, but we can handle this, and it's not just one person that's got to do it, it's all of us having to work together.
It would be almost impossible to say that there weren't periods of time that were very, very stressful, but you know, it really is important to lean on each other, to leverage the team.
The intensity of being in a containment unit, I don't think can be explained. It's just different, and you feel alone. And you wonder, why are we the only ones experiencing this? And you know you're there for a reason.
You just keep going until you have a minute, and then you take that minute, and then you go back out and keep going. I always say that the windshield's a lot bigger than the rearview mirror, because you just have to keep pushing forward.
And despite all the unknowns, people came in, did what they do best, which is take care of patients every single day. Calm resolve, courage, determination, just for our noble mission.
We have been able to be innovative in the way we take care of patients and where we take care of those patients. So we have surged into different areas that maybe they hadn't previously thought about caring for these type of patients. So our emergency department at times has turned into an intensive care unit. Our floors have taken on more sick patients than they're traditionally used to, and they've all stepped up and been able to do a great job with that.
One of the innovative strategies that we came up with is a lot of these patients need to be placed on their belly to breathe. It's called proning. And that tends to help the air exchange in their lungs improve while their lungs are so ill. And so the critical care team, in a way to try to figure out how to manage their workload and to make sure that they did it, that the patients were getting the best care possible, they've created a proning team and a proning schedule. So at certain hours of the day, a little chime sounds, the team assembles, a group of six people go from room to room to room and help reposition those patients and put them in the correct position to breathe.
We're in every intubation, every extubation. We go from seeing patients come in the door to hopefully walk out the door. And it's definitely been challenging, but also very rewarding at times too.
What we've learned is that these patients, for the most part, do get better, and for the most part, they can survive, even the sickest ones. And we've just had to readjust our expectations and understand that it just takes longer than the average patient who requires a ventilator machine.
And we see so many people leaving here healthy, or not, you know, they're repairing, right? They're in there, but they're so much better than when they came in. We can send them on their way.
It was like, oh my gosh, we saved another person.
And you're cheering as they walk out that door, and you know that they're gonna go on with life and be okay. That just takes you to a whole nother level of emotion. So it has been extremely emotional.